Hello, thank you for clicking this video. Before we begin, let us introduce ourselves. My name is Amar, and this is my friend. Her name is Febrina.
We are majoring in architecture at Universitas Pendidikan Indonesia. This video is an assignment for one of the subjects.
And now, we will inform you about the biggest Buddhist temple in the world called Borobudur Temple. Please enjoy!
Borobudur Temple is an architectural masterpiece built by the Shailendra dynasty. Gunadharma is claimed as the name of the architect. His name is recounted from Javanese folktales rather than from written inscriptions. Built between 780 and 840 Anno Domini, Borobudur is the world's largest Buddhist temple located in Magelang, Central Java, Indonesia. The temple was used as a Buddhist temple after some time between the 10th and 15th centuries when it was abandoned. Since its rediscovery in the 19th century and restoration in the 20th century, it has been brought back into a tourist attraction and Buddhist archaeological site.
Borobudur Temple is built as a single large stupa and when viewed from above, takes the form of a giant tantric Buddhist mandala, simultaneously representing the Buddhist cosmology and the nature of mind. This temple is unique to talk about. The elements contained in the Borobudur Temple are fascinating. First of all, Borobudur Temple has a massive square shape with a size of 123 x 123 meters, 42 meters high, and has 10 levels. The 10 levels of this place are divided into 3 zones, namely Kamadhatu, Rupadhatu, and Arupadhatu. Moreover, when we look from above, this temple looks like a lotus. The position of the Buddha statue symbolizes the lotus silk, while the circular courtyard at the top of the Borobudur temple symbolizes the lotus petals.
For the second, the Borobudur temple was built entirely of stone and the walls have 2,672 reliefs, with 1,212 being decorative reliefs and 1,416 telling stories about Buddha. The stories written on the reliefs include Lalita Wistara, Karma Vibhanga, Jatakain Avadana, and Gandavyuha. To read the story in order, you have to read it from the east gate or the ground floor and then turn it clockwise until you return to the east gate. After that, you can continue to the next floor and turn it clockwise again. Do this all the way to the top floor, then you will understand the storyline. In addition, there are 504 Buddha statues, but 248 statues are headless. As many as 57 statue heads have not been installed, and the rest is not clearly known. Besides that, there are 72 stupas that are shaped like upside down bowls with sticks on them. The stupa at Borobudur Temple is often referred to as a bell. There are 3 kinds of stupa, including the main stupa, small stupas as temple ornaments, and terrace stupa.
When I visited there about 5 years ago, I was amazed at the splendor and vastness of this temple. Not only a giant temple, but its surrounding park is also very spacious. There are also several venues for holding events, such as Marga Utama, Samudra Raksa, Lumbini, and Padma Garden. One of the reasons why I'll come back again someday is the sympathetic locals. Their kindness and hospitality bring so much peace and serenity to me. Also, the culture they preserve, the old folk tales they told, and others that are indescribable by words. One thing that I can make sure of is the different spiritual experience when you step into the temple. You can never find it in any other place on earth for its experience. With the chronicle story through the reliefs and the beautiful scenery when you reach the top, especially when staring at the nightfall.
Borobudur Temple has several functions. This temple has 72 stupas that are used by Buddhists to store sacred relics called Datugarbha and places of worship like other Buddhist temples and as a sign of respect for the Buddha. For example, Buddhists make this temple the center of Vesak Day celebrations, which invites many foreign tourists. Photographers will come to take photos of the activities of the monks and Buddhists. At the end of the event, a lantern will be released into the sky. For the general public, Borobudur Temple is used as a tourist spot. On a normal day, both foreign tourists and domestic tourists often capture the moment by taking fun pictures. Borobudur Temple is also one of the best places to enjoy the sunrise and sunset.
Wow, that's incredible, right? I wish people around the world had visited this place at least once. We can see evidence of a magnificent civilization in which there is a building called an artificial mountain. Other than that, as Indonesians, we must take a part in preserving our culture. Because to destroy our culture, there is no need to burn books. Just enough to get people to stop reading them. Thank you for watching this video completely. See you!